transport mechanism. Transport mechanism is any process in which the movement of matter and energy occurs from one part of a system to another. If a substance can cross a membrane, the membrane is said to be permeable to that substance, and if the substance is unable to pass the membrane, it is impermeable. Transport mechanism happens in the cell membrane, also called plasma membrane. This is the structure of the cell membrane. First, let's define the cell membrane. It is a pliable sheet-like structure acting like a boundary, lining, or partition in an organism. It is typically between 4 to 10 nanometers in thickness, surrounds every living cell, delimiting the cell from the environment around it. The function of the cell membrane is selectively permeable to ions and organic molecules and controls the movement of substances in and out of cells. The basic function of the cell membrane is to protect the cell from its surroundings. The cell membrane controls the movement of substances in and out of the cell and organelles. In this way, it is selectively permeable to ions and organic molecules. There are two types of transport mechanism, the passive transport and the active transport. Now, we are going to discuss about passive transport. Passive transport is a means of moving biochemical and other atomic or molecular substances across membrane. This process does not involve chemical energy. It is dependent on the permeability of the cell membrane, which, in turn, is dependent on the organization and characteristics of the proteins. Diffusion and osmosis are both examples of passive transport. Let's see what's the difference between the two. Diffusion is the passive transport of solute. Think about the oxygen and the carbon dioxide, and is the net movement of molecule from an area of high concentration of that substance to an area with lower concentration of that substance. The term simple diffusion refers to a process whereby a substance passes through a membrane without the aid of intermediaries such as an integral membrane protein. The force that drives the substance from one side of the membrane to the other side is the force of diffusion. It is important to organisms because the useful molecules enter the body cells and waste products are removed. Digested food molecules move down a concentration gradient from the intestine to the blood. Some example of diffusion: placing food coloring in a liquid will diffuse the color, or a tea bag placed in a cup of hot water will diffuse into the water. Several factors affect the rate of diffusion of solute, including the mass of the solute. The temperature of the environment, the solvent density, and the distance traveled. Now we go to osmosis. It is the passive transport of water. It is the diffusion of solute. Plant roots function as a semi-permeable membrane, allowing water to infiltrate the roots. The inside of the root contains minerals, sugars, and salts dissolved in water. When water is available in the surrounding soil, osmosis causes it to flow through the root wall to its interior. As the plant absorbs water, pressure builds on the inside. The osmotic pressure brings water in balance with the pressure of the water already inside, keeping the plant from bursting. The movement of osmosis is affected by the concentration gradient. The lower the concentration of the solute within a solvent, the faster osmosis will occur in that solvent. Light and dark, they are also factors of osmosis. Since the brighter the light, the faster osmosis takes place. And that's all for today, so thank you for watching.